I was just, someone was asking me outside, someone recognized me, said, I'm an actor. And someone recognized me and said, hey, Kamal, what are you performing today? Come on, this is what actors are supposed to do. We are asked to perform. I don't know if I'll try a step right now. I'll keep that to the later half. We all begin our life being taught. Taught how to sit, how to walk, who to talk to, how to behave. We are taught every time, every single time. In fact, as kid in schools, we are always taught equations. Equations which become so important that later on they judge our IQ levels based on those equations. So let me present to you one of the equations that we are all very familiar with. A plus B whole square. Yes, sir, this is what we know. We are all very familiar with, and we are being taught about this in school. This equation, if you look at this, if you didn't know what this is equal to, what would you do? I bet you would go to a book, refer a book, or go ask someone who is very knowledgeable, or you would do something in today's age, you just go into the Google search bar and just Google. And hence by, you will know that this equation is equal to a squared plus b squared plus 2ab. Don't worry, I'm not going to teach you maths. But this equation, you know that this is remains true no matter what. You change a to b to x and y, and you can also change this equation to numericals 1 and 2. It remains the same. Now, let us look at this equation again. This equation was designed by someone. For us, we can finish, we can do, find solutions quite easily. Now, as an actor, I would like to look at this equation a different way. What if we change A to a smiley, B to a sad smiley? Now, does anyone have a solution to this? Going by the above equation, the way we resolve, I think this should be equal to smiley square, sad square plus 2 smiley sad. Yes, but definitely no. We all agree that this is not how it works. Now let's look at this equation again. What do you do when such an equation comes to you for which you will never find a solution, for which you've never taught in your books? What would you do? In fact, you thought this is complicated. Imagine there is thunder in this equation. Now, you do something, there are more complications. Let's put thunder with fear. This is, you know, people are creative in film world. Or sometimes when the, you know, sometimes your mind can just go blank. We don't know what to do. This is exactly how, as actors, we feel every time we face the camera and the director says, lights, camera, action. We are supposed to perform. We are expected to perform. Then what do actors do? Where do they read? What do they do? This is where the actor always relies on cognitive memory. A very technical term. In fact, a lot of people here or outside think actors are not technical. They don't solve equations. They just come out of the mother's womb and we start acting. No. In fact, I would say each one of us here are wonderful, brilliant actors as kids. We just lose it somewhere, this so-called journey of life. So let me look at this equation now. And I also used to solve equations as a kid. And just that my equations never used to look like so boring like this. They were telling me, but my equations looked something like this. And, or something like this. You know, every time some event happened at school, I always realized that I always wanted to change myself, do different expressions, do different characters. I don't know about how people used to recollect above of my IQ levels in school, but one thing that I know is that I loved this. I loved drama, I loved acting, I loved theater. This was my world. Okay. Okay, someone wanted that reaction. Sometimes I also was asked to change my gender. That was for the school, don't worry. But this is what we are expected to do every time. We don't have to feel shy. We don't have emotions. We are not science. We are not anything. We just are dropped down from mother's womb and then perform. So if I recollect myself of my what I was as in school, I always was used to do something very interesting. What was left after the teachers taught something on the board? They look something like this. Very simple, chalk pieces. They're half broken, full. And what I used to do is take them back home or sit in the back bench during the intervals of time and work on them until they look something like this. Or like this. Showing different forms, different faces, experiencing expressions became a passion right as a kid for me. So what happened is slowly things started evolving within me. And I could see that the drama was unfolding. Again, I don't know the ranking on the report cards. I don't want to mention it. I was good in the school, but I don't want to mention it. But somewhere down the line, my IQ levels more or not something that was important for me, but I started creating this small world within me that was very personal. Nobody knew about me, and I liked it. I loved it. So next, what happened? All this, you know, in Hindi, they call it KLPD. They used to call this KLPD in school. So doing all this KLPD, I got into architecture. Now, this was supposed to be a wonderful profession. I finished architecture, I was given some site to work on. They said it was a waiting area of a restaurant. So how does a waiting area restaurant look like? Okay, tell us what chairs to use, what to do, and all those things. But my waiting area looked something like this. Something which was more personal, more emotional, more to deal with the psychology of people. What would they do at when they come to such a place? This is something that I used, the kund. You know, the step level that created for the waiting area. The landscape, the seating area, everything transformed. Getting the exterior to interior, the landscape to spread across. Expressing myself is again a passion, like you see. Then this changed on. This expression cannot be restrained to one way. You can't think in one way like A plus B is equal to A squared plus B squared plus 2AB. It has to change. The context changes. And it kept on changing. It kept on evolving. Be it design, be it set design, or sometimes furniture design. This was something that I designed for a friend. And this, can you tell what this is? This is a book rack. Someone wanted a book rack, and I thought, let us make it colorful so that you can stack these books easily, pull them out whenever you want, and they're all crisscrossed so that you could, you know, see them even when you're sitting on the chair and you got a workstation. So things started evolving. As actors, this is what we do. We create different windows within us, windows through which we can peep out sometimes, look at some expressions, say hello, hi to them, revisit them, and sometimes keep it in our memory so that sometimes we can revisit. Such window that I remember a lot was something that I remember a lot was my admiration to nature. Nature has wonderful ways of expressing. It has wildness, it has calmness, it has soothing nature. It has something that is different ways of telling us different expressions exist for us, before us. So these are one of the few of the photographs that I've taken, and I get connected to the nature through my lens and see what I can express. But this is something that was more observing. But what is it that got me to do something to connect mine to my heart, through my hand, into something that was more real? Art, painting. I used to do this exercise whenever I was between my shoots, come back from shoot and keep working on it. And I used to, you know, sit on my canvas boards and start painting. Painting became a way of expressing what was there in my heart and bring it out onto the canvas. On a period of time, I created so many and so many that, you know, it created a different life for me. So what I started doing is, once the art was created, I started giving a different meaning to, you know, a different meaning to art. That is, to start interacting with it. Can I say something through art? So I started creating this character called Minnu. This is a character which formed a world in itself, which talked about joy, about sadness, about its bravery, about a lot of things. Like this painting, if you see, this talked about feticides, female feticides, girl child, how, you know, children are killed, you know, as girls, as soon as they're born. So I started addressing, I started talking to Minnu, like how Minnu started talking to me. So Minnu became a world in itself, wonderful, all that I created. And if you see the small windows that were getting created one after the other, and each window was different from the other. It never had one way of doing it. And it never got restricted to a sphere. It was always expanding. It was trying to form a new form. And it was trying to come out and explore new ways in which, and this basically gave it a shape. This shape is not something that I thought of. This came and it basically gave it a movement. And this, what does it do? This is what actors rely on, cognitive memory. And it helped me perform in different films, in different characters and different ways. And it never had any restricted motive. And this, I think, will be continuing even for much, much later. So here, I'd like to show you one of the clips. If you just watch the clip, you'll have 100 people waiting at the, you know, in the unit. Maybe the lightman is waiting for the orders from the director, and the camera and the crane are rolling, and you still have to perform. Watch this clip.
Rekbar, president avute ratraatru kuchan pani chesna avasaram ledra. Government odi chesthe dabbu ledu.
Re, ledra.
I look at this as solving an equation, an equation that was not known to me, something that came around me through different emotions, exploring different things. We may not do it in our daily lives, a lot of us, because of our job and all of lot of things. But if I look into myself, this is what I learned. That there will be an equation in our life which we will not be able to solve, be it marital, be it professional, be it in our business, many a time for which there are no solutions in books. If you look deep into yourself, I think you would have already found a solution and it already been solved. Thanks.
Hi, that's me at TEDx Deccan. Please like, share and comment. And don't forget to subscribe. Let's more color.